Adobe just dropped this super cool tool into Photoshop beta, Generative Fill, and it's been making waves in the creative world. We've already dived deep into how to use this powerhouse of a tool, but what if you don't have Photoshop? Can you get your hands on Generative Fill for free? Absolutely. Let me show you how. The tech wizards at Adobe have worked their magic and added Generative Fill to Firefly, their slick AI image generator. The best part? Firefly is absolutely free. Firefly is packing an AI image generator, a swanky tool for creating text effects, and a recolor vector tool. Now you can also generate AI content straight in your image. Let's take it for a spin. If you're a Firefly newbie, hop onto firefly.adobe.com. Create an Adobe account or sign in with your Adobe ID. And don't forget to jump into Firefly's Discord server. There's a boatload of cool stuff happening over there, including a whole bunch of training sessions. Need a hand with using the shiny new tools in Firefly? I've got you covered. You can check out my training videos right here and here. Let's see what this new Generative Fill tool is all about. Select an image. We'll get to uploading one in a minute, but let's warm up with one of the sample images. Use the Add tool like a paintbrush. Brush over the area you want to switch up. No need to be a perfectionist here. In the prompt box, type what you're looking to see, or leave it blank and see what Photoshop cooks up. Click Generate. You'll get four choices. Pick the one that makes you go, wow. It's so easy. The Add tool leaves a brush stroke, but let's say you accidentally brush over an area you don't want to change. No worries, just switch to the Subtract tool and erase the stroke. The Settings button switches up your brush size, hardness, and opacity. The background button is your quick fix to selecting a background. Type in what you'd rather see instead of the current background. I'm going to leave the prompt box blank and let Photoshop surprise me. Super wow! Not feeling any of the options? Just click More for a new set of choices. Firefly is a real speed demon when it comes to generating content. You'll never run out of options. When you're happy with the results, click Download. Adobe leaves a little watermark on your image so everyone knows it's AI. I see where they're going with this, but if you open the image in Photoshop beta, you can easily remove the watermark. And guess what? Photoshop beta doesn't add the watermark, only Firefly does. To learn how to use Generative Fill in Photoshop beta, check out this video. Now let's try generating content in one of your own images. Click Upload Image and pick your favorite shot. I'm going to play around with an image I whipped up in Midjourney. First, I'm going to erase the jumbled text. Just click Remove and brush over the parts you want gone. Remember, if you accidentally go over something you want to keep, just switch to Subtract. It's a super quick cleanup job. Now I'll get rid of those pesky black bars. Sure, it'd be nice to have a few more selection tools, like the Marquee tool, but our trusty brush is up for the job. This image goes with the song Mad World. Let's test Firefly's skills in generating text. Well, no. All AI image generators still struggle with creating accurate text, but I did manage to pull it off in the end. If you're working on fine details, zoom in. Use the key combination Command or Control and the plus key. And the bracket keys quickly make your brush larger and smaller. Let's spruce up this Baroque library and see how it compares with Generative Fill in Photoshop Beta. Photoshop Beta is packing a few more selection tools and lets you use other editing tools on your image. Plus, each generation is on its own layer, so you can go back and tweak the AI-generated content anytime. But the results are looking pretty good in both programs. One thing missing from Firefly's Generative Fill tool is outpainting, the ability to expand the frame. But it does look like this cool feature might be popping up in Firefly soon. If you're not a Photoshop user, now might be the perfect time to dive in. It seems like Adobe is blending Firefly's tools into Photoshop Beta. I'm totally pumped to see what they roll out next. Whether you're a Photoshop pro or a Firefly fan, or just someone starting on this exciting creative journey, remember the only limit is your imagination. So go ahead and experiment, play, and keep exploring the limitless possibilities. Let us know the craziest thing you've generated in Firefly in the comments below. If this video gave you a boost, make sure to like it and click subscribe for more. This is Jen at Making the Photo. Let's make something amazing together.